my PlayStation is so loud right now. So loud. Alright, let's continue this. Should continue me where I left off yesterday. Alright. Okay. All the noises were like really quiet for some reason.
What's going on?
Nothing.
No, this is your clutch.
I know where the clutch is.
Do you want me to show you how to do this or not?
Yes, but I know where the clutch is.
Okay, fine. All right, you do it yourself, okay?
Fine.
I swear if she runs into a post because she lets go of the clutch, that'd be hilarious.
Hey! What are you doing? You can't park here.
I'm just here to pick up, sir.
It's private property. Now turn around, get the hell out of here. Come on.
Okay.
Move it.
Yep. Okay. You know what, though? I think I'm just gonna wait right here. You can go back to doing your guard the cornfields thing.
This is Officer Moore at the gate. We got an issue here. Hey, listen, asshole. This is a restricted area. I told you, get the hell out of here. Okay. Hey, you just wait right there. I told you. Move it.
It's like I was trying to say. I'm just here
you
to pick up...
Did you not see that sign?
Oh, look at that. That's kind of hard to miss.
I'm authorized to use deadly force.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you.
Whoa, what's going on?
I'm sorry, Miss Whitaker.
It's fine,
Jim. Do you know this asshole?
Yeah, he's with me. He's with me.
Sorry, ma'am. I didn't know that...
It's fine. Honestly, I apologize.
Shh. Oh, and Jim!
Deacon!
I'm not with her. She's with me.
Hold on tight.
Slick.
Why do you always do that?
Do what?
Act like such a dick.
Oh, come on. He started it.
What are you, five?
Hey, watch the clutch. Remember, you gotta give it enough gas, rev up the RPMs.
I got this.
Yeah, I can hear. Where are we headed?
Over to the dam. That's a nice quiet road, right?
Were you driving? No.
Are we still going out tonight? You said something might come up.
Crap, yeah, Boozer and the boys want to ride down to Clam Estate, visit Jack.
So you're gonna blow me off to go see some guy in prison?
Jack's not some guy.
I know. I was kidding.
Oh shit, look out!
Oh god. Oh my god. Jesus. I don't know what it is, but every time I'm on a bike with you, some idiot in a truck tries to run us off the road.
Oh my god. No. Listen. You did great. Most people, they would have panicked. They would have oversteered, and that would have gotten us killed.
I almost did get us killed. I wasn't paying attention, and I was distracted.
Hey, it's okay. Just breathe. You're okay. Wait a second. What did you mean, distracted?
No, it's just stuff going on at work. It's nothing. I just...
Oh. Okay. No. I just thought maybe you saw my new patch.
Your what? No. Nomad? Wait, you quit the club?
No, I didn't quit the club. I would never quit the club. Nomad. What it means is, well, I'll be less involved from now on.
Deke, I didn't ask you to do that.
Oh, I know. And if you had, I would have said no. You ready to try this again?
Yeah. I mean, no, but yeah, I will. Okay.
Thank you for saving my life.
Well, you know, I do what I can.
Hey, the clutch.
I know what the clutch is.
Okay, none of that.
Deacon.
So, you think your parents are gonna come?
To the wedding? I don't know.
I mean, you know, I thought if I stepped back from the MC that,
I don't think it's gonna matter to them, Deacon.
But you're gonna at least tell them.
Yeah, if you want me to. Look, it's just, I'm not gonna change who I am and who you are. Make my uptight, middle-class parents happy.
Okay. Look out.
I see them.
Hey, are they headed to your work?
Oh, shit. What about the MC? Are any of them coming now that you've gone Nomad?
Oh, I don't know. It's probably been a while since any of them set foot in a chapel. And you really want 27 Harleys rolling up in that little church in Marion Forks?
Yeah. You know what? As a matter of fact, I do.
Okay.
Miss Whitaker's returning. What's going on?
I don't know.
Miss Whitaker.
Yeah.
Chief's been trying to get a hold of you, says it's urgent.
It's always urgent. Let him know I'll be right there.
Okay.
I gotta go.
Hey.
Sorry. It's fine. It's probably just a fire alarm or something small.
Okay. Knock him dead.
Love you.
Is that where the outbreak
just call
happens?
Me later.
Clown.
Addie, I'm sorry.
Whatever.
Addie.
Whatever, Ricky.
I'm sorry.
God damn.
Clearance. Clearance. O'Brien, this is St. John. Come back.
Okay.
O'Brien, this is St. Just answer your goddamn radio!
St. John, didn't think I'd hear from you again.
Yeah, neither did I. All right, listen, that night you bugged out. You told me that you didn't take any civilians. You just took Nero personnel, feds, people with clearance.
I told you there was
Shut up. Listen to me. Sarah, my wife, she had clearance. She had her ID badge with her the night that I put her on your chopper. Do me a favor, look it up. Sarah Irene Whitaker. She worked at Cloverdale. She had federal clearance. She was doing, research, pharmaceutical. I don't know what she the hell she
okay,
was doing. Just
okay.
Do me.
I'll see what I can find.
Okay, great. O'Brien, remember, you owe me.
Yeah. O'Brien out.
Interesting.
Do you?
What the hell? What happened to my weapons?
They're like a bunch of Alzheimer's patients, only pissed off, stronger,
okay.
And you want to tear your guts out. Just a sec. Gotta open the gate.
Deke. Hey, I heard. You know? I mean, what you did for us, how you... The Rippers, all of them, I know you had to do it.
Uh-huh.
What else was gonna stop them, you know?
Yeah, look, Blair, I'm not proud of what I had to do. You know that, right? I mean, we had to... Look, they were coming.
Yeah, I know. You don't have to explain anything to me. I was here when they attacked, remember? I don't know. I guess I'm just tired, you know?
Yeah, I know.
Is that all I have? I believe it is.
Yep. Deke, take care now.
Shush. Oh, yeah.
Jesus, man. When the Rippers hit us, I thought we were all goners, you know?
Yeah, I know. I heard what you did, you know. About how you took them on. Christ. Yeah, well, don't believe everything you hear.
Got it. See you later, man.
Got good shit in stock today.
Buzz.
Okay. I'll top you off.
No idea how to fix it.
Your bike's looking good now.
This thing is...
What else can I get you?
Oh, I think that's about it. Actually, what kind of skins were this, I guess?
Yeah, that'll last you.
This.
That's a good piece. Nice and sturdy. Yeah, good part, that one.
Nah.
I'll be here, if
All
you
right.
need me.
That's that.
See you around.
Buzz Simon to the rescue. Never mind.
Two dogs back.
What? Where the hell is he?
He took off when he saw me. Jeremy followed him. I know. I tried to stop him.
Jesus, where, Ricky?
Jeremy tracked him to the old sawmill, said Two Dog looked like he was holed up in the abandoned Nero camp.
Okay, I'll take care of him.
I need you to bring back his knife.
Wait, you need proof? Jesus. All fine, great, whatever you say.
Don't let him get away, Deke. Who knows how many bodies are buried out there?
Yeah, I got this.
Going bounty hunting.
I was in my classroom when.
Just a sec. Gotta open the gate.
St. John, this is O'Brien.
O'Brien, what do you got?
I need to see you in person.
Jesus, O'Brien, just would you tell me what you found? Is she alive or isn't she?
I have something to give you.
O'Brien?
I've transmitted the coordinates. Meet me there. O'Brien out.
O'Brien? Oh, God damn it.
Deep. Iron Mike's looking for you. He said...
Boozman, listen. Just tell him I'll be back. I gotta... You remember what I told you? The night that Sarah died, Nero, they bugged out. They only took their own people, feds, and people who had federal clearance levels.
Deke, what the hell are you talking?
Look, it's probably nothing, but there's something I gotta do. Deacon out. At the sawmill, going after him.
Be careful, Deacon. Remember,
there's a big fucking horde here? Yeah, I remember. Thanks, Deacon out.
All right, Two Dog. Where are you hiding?
Information? What information, O'Brien? What the hell can you possibly have left to say
that I would give a damn about? Another MMU. Wonder what Nero left behind this time. Come on, you son of a bitch.
Nowhere to run, brother!
Here it is.
I do not think I have what I need to tackle this. Wow. Like, look at this. I'm still tagging. Oh, they disappear after a while, that's why. You kind of want to wait and see like what they do. Like, look at them all. Surprised they're not like awake yet. But yeah, like they disappear after a while, see? Should be waking up here soon. Curious on what these guys are gonna do when they wake up. There's a huge horde in there. I mean, it's just ridiculous. So many of them. Like, that whole building is just filled with them. Oop, here they come. Oh, there went that dude. Of course, the guy that I need to kill just ran off over there. Look at them all. Not what I wanted. So many of them. I think it is. The hordes are fucking terrifying, but I don't know, that he's pretty good. Alright, so oh my god, I need a new controller.
I got a use for you.
But I do not have what I need to take on a horde just yet. A horde is literally like hundreds of zombies all at once. Like, it's just massive. Yeah, we gotta get out of here. Yeah, I can't deal with that. There's just too many of them. If I put this here, maybe that should give me a clear run. What the f? Okay, this is what I'm talking about, a horde. That's just like a small portion of it. Yeah. I do not have the firepower to deal with this. Oh my god, there's more over there. Yeah. You know what, do I have tractors? No, I didn't. Wait, do I? Right here. It's, I don't know if this will attract them or not. It's not. I kind of want them to come out. Whoop, here comes some. I'm actually just shocked they're not coming after me. Yeah, I can't deal with this because I do not have enough bullets for everybody. So I'm going to have to do a different story here. Or a different part of this story. Where is it? Right, let's do Nero, Nero, Nero. Alright, I have to do this. So that means, oh wow. Alright, so I have to go to here first. I have to get gas for my bike, because you actually do use gas for your bike. Like, you actually use up gas, you have to like keep replenishing it and all that. Pretty cool, actually. Be annoying though. Especially when we run out of gas in the middle of the night.
Damn, not fun. Knife.
Somebody's the at the noises.
Gate. This is Radio Free.
I know
Oregon.
Him. The Let
truth
him in.
She'll set you free.
Nah, I don't think so, Cope. Not today.
You here to buy something?
Hey, Buzz.
Yeah, feel.
All right, I got you. Don't beat her up too bad. Should have new shit.
Shut up.
Can I? Actually, we're gonna go up to that.
Later. Stop by. Deacon St. John. How've you been?
Sniper contracts? Interesting. Really? Turn, damn it. Alright, this is so.
Hold on, I'll get the gun.
Oh, contacts. Alright, on this game, I do not recommend driving around in the middle of the night like this. Because there's hordes that are out running around. Hit a bike!
Yeah,
go!
Who's
get on
what's
it!
Up?
Go! Go, bitch!
It's no worries, brother. I mean, it followed me, you know? Wouldn't leave me alone. What was I supposed to do?
Oh, man.
Hey.
I hate those dogs.
Yeah,
or wolves.
Hey, named him Jack.
Yeah, Jack would have loved that.
No, he wouldn't have. Which is why I did it.
easy,
boy. All right, enough. Okay, Deke, I gotta go. Who's around?
You're welcome.
Deke, you there?
No.
Bored. Figured I'd see if I remembered how to make anything. Stop by when you can. I think you'll like it.
Booze, man. Thank you, brother. I'll be by.
Oh, I see it's
so what the hell?
I managed to recruit a few guys who I trust, who like me, aren't happy with what's going on.
So why am I here?
I wanted to give you this. You were right about your wife.
When did you get this?
When Silver Lake evacuated, they took Nero personnel, federal officials, and well, Sarah Irene Whitaker had a Class 4 federal clearance level.
Clearance level.
The wife bugged out with a recon unit east of Fort Rock.
Take me there.
No.
No. Well, you got a ride. We're all friends now.
The base is gone.
What?
A year ago. Local militia group.
Militia group? Where's their camp?
We don't know.
How the hell can you not know? You got a helicopter. You got satellites.
Somewhere around Crater Lake, but it's a no-fly zone, okay? They got outposts, rockets, RPGs.
Crater Lake.
Crater Lake. I wanted to tell you about the work we're doing. Studying the infected, the freaks. They're evolving. As bad as things are right now, they're gonna get worse. lot worse.
Shit about any of that. Boozer? Booze man, come back.
Yeah, Dean.
Hey, listen to me. A year ago, we were with Mike. We were thinking about riding south. The Byzantium Pass was blocked. There was no way through, and he said that he knew another way.
Iron Mike, he's not too happy with us right now.
Just listen to me. Do you remember what he said?
Iron Mike? Yeah, he was bragging about knowing every goat trail in 100 miles. Said there was a trail that went around now. That's... something.
Teal's it!
Sarah's alive?
Okay, listen to me. O'Brien, they, Boozer, he found her ID badge. Boozer,
holy shit! Time to go!
Dave, never lost hope.
Fuck you, lady.
You never gave up. What's going on
there? I don't know, Boozer. I don't know, but... God, if there's even
I'm running
a chance
from a horde right now, can't talk. Hang up.
I gotta find her.
Shit, I gotta go. Ricky and Annie need help putting up a shelter or some goddamn thing. Look, I'll see you when you get back to camp. Boozer.
Okay. See you, Boozer.
Deacon, where are you?
Hey, Ricky. I got some shit I gotta take care of.
Are you coming back?
Am I coming back? What do you mean?
Boozer told
okay, look, there's nothing to tell.
There's no way over the Sanium Pass, you know that.
Yes, I'm coming back. Listen, like I said, I got some shit to do. Deacon out.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free.
Nope, not in the mood.
I know him.
Do you now, huh? Alright, I wanna fuel my bike quick.
Hey, Deacon.
Buzz.
Shit, you really need a lot of fuel.
Sure, alright.
I'm here if you need me, man.
Oh, only thing that sucks about this game is a lot of running back and forth, but...
All right, let's see what the old man's got to say.
He gonna yell. Temporarily lock you out of the northern regions. Sure.
You know a way over the Teelson Pass. You told me once that
I told you nothing. Go on. I can't help you, Deke.
Just draw me a goddamn map.
After everything you've done.
After everything what about what you've done, old man? Huh?
Sherman's camp, the things that
you get out of here.
Hey,
you leave me.
Listen to me. What if you could take it all back? Huh? What if you could fix it? I thought I put Sarah on a chopper. I felt relieved. How fucked up is that? I was relieved, Mike. That's what I've been living with.
And now you're chasing ghosts. You think finding your old lady, if she's alive, you think that's gonna fix it? Make you whole?
I don't know, but I gotta try.
All right. If I do this, what you want, show you the way over the pass, you don't come back. All right, you promise me you don't come back.
I got you.
What? I actually kind of like that guy, even though he's kind of an idiot. And they brought Ewo back? Really? Interesting. It's kind of surprising, actually.
Shit, now I gotta talk to Boozer.
Do not know my way out of here. Help me, I'm trapped in a paper bag. I can't get out. There we go. Alright. This should be
sounds like there's a militia down there. They're making the fight for the goddamn freakers. Well, we're up here pissing our pants.
Okay, so what do you want to do? Go down there? Oh. I mean, I'm not that worried about the whole Ewo thing.
Deke, long time no see.
How's life treating you, Blair?
I played a little bit of GTA for a guy on this, and it was instantly one dude in God mode, so.
Here you go.
Yeah. They need to fix that stuff.
Yep. Deke, take care now.
Alright, we got fuel.
Holy shit.
Bruiser, I...
Last winter, we were up on Farewell Ridge. We were watching the freaks. Thousands of them. I mean, too many to count.
Yeah, I remember.
All I could think was, every one of us, man, woman, and child, are now homeless. A bunch of goddamn refugees. Yeah. What belongs to them now?
We'll survive.
Yeah, we've been doing that all right. Surviving isn't living. Something Jack used to say.
Yeah, I don't know.
Doesn't matter when you hit the road, where you're heading out to, but you damn well better know where you're coming home to.
Thank God, but
you know, we never talked about it.
I don't think I might just
while
stop
we still
playing
wore
GTA.
The colors.
This is annoying.
All this time out in the freak show and shit like this didn't matter anymore.
Habit, I think. Last two mongrels on Earth, Farewell Originals.
The biker boys, most badass drifters on the broken road.
Damn straight.
Yeah, I guess we did become sort of a brand.
We were a lot of things, but we were never a brand.
When we rode out of Farewell, without Sarah, without
I mean,
Jack,
I'll still probably play every now and again, but it's... I'm not gonna be doing too much of fighting unless it's in, like, a private lobby or something.
Everything that mattered was gone. Except this.
You're a nomad again, huh?
Yep, I guess I am.
Thank you. It's a shame. I like GTA, but they just don't seem to be like patching any of these goddamn glitches.
Inside, let's go. If she's out there, you can find her.
Deke, you ready?
Yeah, Mike, I'm ready. Yeah, sure, Mike. Whatever you say.
Okay.
Hey.
Heard Big Mike has taken you over the pass?
Yep.
You really think she's still alive? Billions of people are dead, but somehow she made it.
Hey, we made it, didn't we? If I give up now, if I don't do this, well, then I'm just gonna end up like
us, right? Like Iron Mike, like Boozer? What'd you call us, campers? Yeah?
You go and you find your woman.
Can't find somebody who's dead.
You know where to find me.
And you know what? You know what I think, Deacon? I think that you're afraid to be here. You're afraid to be a part of something. Mm-hmm. We need you here, and that scares the hell out of you.
I'm sorry.
It doesn't even make sense, but okay.
Yeah, me too.
You ready? Yeah, I want to get the hell out of here.
Come on, this way.
Okay, I'm following you.
Ah, my eye. Why is my eye burning? Oh, it's hard to do this with one hand.
Fishing once before, you know.
Oh shit.
I got one. Didn't know what the hell to do with it.
That sounds like Jack.
Oh, you ran a pretty tight club. Well, you boys raised some hell back in the day. But I don't think you murdered anyone. Not in cold blood.
It's not murder if they shoot at you first.
Summer?
A few.
Thousands. Too many to count. Highway be bumper to bumper with SUVs and campers chock full of sunburned moms, beer-chugging dads, and their snot-nosed kids. Goddamn rainbow of floppy hats, Hawaiian shirts, and flippy-flops. All summer long they come. A trail of colorful ants from L.A. to Farewell to here. Nonstop.
I'm glad I avoided road trips out here that time of year.
The help.
I don't have a choice, Mike.
Fair enough. Come on, just follow me.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, you can't outrun them. Oh, this is Ripper territory. Forgot about that.
This is as far as I go. Keep following the trail. It'll take you down the mountain, on into the Diamond-like Valley. I wish you luck. Hope you're right about your old lady still being alive.
She is.
Well, maybe so. But you gotta ask yourself, Deke, what does it matter if everyone else is dead?
I've memorized your face, just in case the need lasts me eternity. It's a shame that it ain't enough for me. Life's for the living, I won't be giving up.
They got this music so loud.
You taught me how to, you taught me how to love. Take all I cherish, beat me till my heart is numb. Life's for the living, I won't be giving up.
So loud.
Even though I know you would tell me to.
If you're out there, I'll find you.
Try again!
What the hell?
What the hell?
Jesus,
I don't know what we would have done without you, man.
Oh, come on.
Hey, okay, all right, all right, all right. It's dead. It's cool.
Man of the hour.
Oh, God.
I'm Russell, Glenn Russell. This is Private Mullins.
Rick.
Hey, Rick. I'm Deacon St. John. Did you say private?
Yeah. Yes, sir. Deschutes County Militia.
You're not from around here. You come over the pass?
No. I've just been drifting. I came over the salt flats east of Silver Lake.
What the hell are you doing out here, man? How'd you get across the 97?
Whoa. Jesus, man.
What?
This guy just saved your freaking life.
The colonel told us to look out for anybody entering the territory, north or south.
Freaking slow your roll, man. We'll let the captain deal with that, okay?
Huh.
He just killed a freaking ranger, dude. Come with us. We got a camp just by Diamond Lake. Get you 3 hots and a cot. Least we can do.
Okay, yeah, sounds good. What about Flores? We can't just leave him here.
Wow.
You stay here. I'll come back with some fuel.
No!
Listen, stay here. Use his ammo if you gotta. You'll be fine. Okay? Let's go.
Following you.
Everybody has motorcycles in this game.
You gotta stick with me, okay? Been having some trouble with squatters out here the past few weeks. A patrol picks you up, could be trouble.
Okay, got it. So, Deschutes County Militia?
Look, man, all I know is they feed me. They want me to salute and yes, sir, I salute and say yes, sir.
How big's your outfit?
Camp out here, we got 100, maybe more. Hard to keep track. Back at HQ, a whole lot more than that.
Yeah, okay. Any women?
Hell, that what you're about? Well, you can forget it. Girls got rules about that. Fraternizing. Yeah, that. Look, you pull your weight, follow orders, nobody messes with you. Women same as the men. Don't matter to the colonel.
I'm not, Listen, I'm looking for some people and a woman that I rode with a year back or so. They would have come over from Silver Lake, and they would have been at one of those Nero refugee camps, I think.
Silver Lake? Jesus, man. Silver Lake's been gone a lot longer than that.
Yeah, it's too goddamn easy to lose track of time out of here, you know? Anyway, you guys, do you pick anyone up? Survivors, I mean, from the refugee camp?
Maybe. Like I said, it's a big freaking army, you know? Ask the captain. He came in across the salt flats, I think. He might know.
The captain?
Yeah, Corey. He commands the Diamond Lake outpost. We're almost there.
What? He's got my name.
This is it.
It's Corporal Russell. Open up.
This is interesting. He said they're basically like an army. Oh, he's a militia. Militia.
Report.
Captain, sir, we had him. We did. Found his bike, still smoking.
I bet you lost him, huh?
No, sir. I mean, yeah, we lost him. We ran into a rager, sir.
Where's Mullins? Flores?
Flores is dead, sir. I'll have Mullins with a body.
That'll be all, Corporal. Go get some fuel. Head back to Mullins. You know what to do.
Yeah. Yes, sir. If it wasn't for this man, we'd all be dead, sir. I sort of promised him some food and a safe place to camp tonight, sir.
Corporal, get the fuck out of here. And you are?
Name's Deacon St. John.
Name's Corey. Derek Corey. Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm sorry. Sorry, I'm a little tired. I've been on the road for a long time. Your man Russell said you were recruiting.
Well, are you interested?
I've been looking to settle down. Yeah, find a camp. I'm interested.
Come on.
So, how long you been drifting?
Hard to say. You lose track of time out there, you know?
So, where'd you get your gear? Ammo?
Well, there's a couple of camps I used to do runs for. Bounty hunting, mostly.
Freaks? Or men?
Both. I had a reputation for being able to track shit down, you know?
Oh, which camps? Where are they?
You know, past the Farewell Valley. It doesn't matter. They're gone now. They're overrun. Russell said you were there when Silver Lake was overrun.
Yeah. That was a shit show, I can tell you.
Any survivors?
A few.
Go! 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 You gotta move your ass! You think you're gonna outrun the freaks? Hell no!
Here. Take this. Militia script. Camp credits. Payment for helping my men. Use them at any of the commissaries.
Okay.
You gonna join up? Stick around. We're getting ready to ride out of here soon.
Getting ready to ride out where?
You said you had some tracking skills.
Yeah, some.
This isn't the life of a drifter. We're fighting a war out here. You sure you're up for it?
Is that the best you got?
I can recruit you. But the colonel is the only one who can swear you in. You stick around. Give us a hand. I'll take you to him myself.
I'll be here.
Good.
Jesus. Jesus, motherfucker has my ring. He took it from Sarah. He had to take it from Sarah because she wouldn't have given it to him. So that means that she's got to be here. He doesn't look like militia.
Move! 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 Come on!
Hey. You don't look very militia to me.
Nah, man. Name's Wade. Wade Taylor. You can call me Wade.
Deacon St. John.
Holy shit! Deacon St. John? Is your old man a preacher or something?
No.
Man, that is a hell of a name.
All right, listen.
You wait. See this, man? This is some crazy shit.
Yeah.
Whew. So what, you joining up, becoming an army man, playing soldier and shit?
I don't know. Maybe. Listen, you look like you just came in from out the shit, right?
Yeah, man, yesterday. Okay. Yesterday. I've been waiting to see the colonel, whatever the hell that is.
Traveling with some people, we got separated. You see anyone that looked like this around here?
Nah, man. Ooh, she is a looker. I'd hit that, you know. I gotta go, man. They're checking me for lice or some shit. Good luck to you, Deacon St. John. Jesus, what a name.
Jesus, that dude's fucked up. He wouldn't remember Sarah if she slapped him in the face. Come on, Sarah. Come on. Where the hell are you? You're here. Somewhere. Maybe in these tents. maybe in here. No, she wouldn't be in the mechanics area. She never knew a wrench from a screwdriver. The infirmary. I mean, with her background, that's where she would be, right? Nope, not here. Check this one. Oh, damn it. She's not here either. It's gotta be the one. Sarah? Sarah, you in here? Shit, not here. Oh, God damn it, she's not here. She's not here, but... Right, yeah, it couldn't be that easy. Could it?
St. John, are you on this channel? Corporal Russell said you had a radio.
Yeah, I'm here.
Meet me at the gate.
On my way.
How's it going? New around here? Name's Ava Bergstrom. Friends call me Bergie.
Deacon St. John, yeah, I just got here.
Well, Deacon St. John, you do your job, and we'll get along just fine. How's that?
Yes, ma'am.
See ya.
Getting ready to ride out. You still coming?
Ready when you are.
So you put a lot of work into this.
Yeah, some.
Open it up!
Are you any good? Can you ride?
Yeah. Yeah, I can ride.
Do you want to join the militia? You're gonna have to prove it to me. See if you can keep up, St. John.
So what the hell happened back there? I mean, it looks like a forest fire, but the stumps are charred. That means that the timber was cut before it was burned.
You got a good eye. We call it the dead zone. We use the timber to build our barricades, then burn the slash. From the outpost, we can see a horde coming along before it reaches us.
What? You're gonna burn all the buildings, too, so the newts and the swarmers have nowhere to sleep?
You know you're freaks, huh?
Like I said, I've been out in the ship for a long time. So that's your plan, huh? The militia, I mean, to burn everything to the ground?
We're fighting a war out here, St. John. We'll do whatever it takes to win.
A war?
That's what it is, isn't it? War? You've been out in this shit. You've seen the hordes. The only thing that's gonna stop them is an army. Our army.
It's gonna take way more than an army.
We have a plan. The colonel lets you join, we'll fill you in. So, Silver Lake, you asked about survivors. You looking for someone?
No, not really. I mean, look, there were some folks that I rode with once, and I thought maybe they ended up there.
I thought maybe you were after someone. For a bounty, I mean.
Yeah, no. I tracked men over long distances before, but not this far. No bounty's worth that.
This is it.
Hey, Corporal. The captain's here.
It's done, sir.
Make sure you make a marker.
Yes, sir.
All right. You two head back to Diamond Lake. Grab, Taylor was his name?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Take him to the colonel. I'll be there in 1800.
Sir?
Military time, Corporal. You're supposed to know this by now.
Oh, yes, sir.
Get the fuck out of here.
Yes, sir.
You find something?
How long is,
Vasquez?
How long has Vasquez been with you guys?
A couple of weeks, maybe more.
Well, he's been busy.
What the hell?
You guys been having trouble with supply runs, marauder attacks?
Yeah.
Okay, we're gonna go on foot from here.
On foot? Why?
Because Vasquez came out here for a reason. I can't track him from the bike.
God.
Where do we start?
It's been snowing, so there won't be any boot prints. Come on, I want to look inside the cabin.
Okay, I'm following you.
You said he stole rations? Ammo?
Yes.
This is an MRE. It's half-eaten, so looks like your men rode up on him when he wasn't expecting it. His bike's still out front, which means that he went out the back. Wait, over here.
What'd you find?
The fence has been cut. And no rust.
So it was cut recently?
Yeah. Come on, this way.
I see that red marker.
Hey, hold on for a second. Look, over here.
Tracks?
Yeah, we're in luck.
Over here.
This way. Wait,
hold up. You find something?
Yeah, shell casing. Recently fired. He stopped to shoot at something. Come on, down here.
Yeah, Wolf. Can't fool me, I see that.
Get out of here!
What are you doing? That ever worked for you? Yelling at a wolf?
Depends.
Look out! More wolves!
I see him.
That's the last of them.
Yeah, it looks like it. Nice work.
Yeah, neat. I want to take a look at this thing. Looks like the MREs weren't enough for your man. Clean gunshot, right through the head.
Yeah, the wolves must have heard the shot. Decided they wanted it more than Vasquez.
Yeah, the rest of the pack came at us from back that way, from the east.
You think they chased off Vasquez, leaving one to guard the carcass?
That's my guess.
Come on, let's see if you're right.
You guys got a lot of wolves out here? Ones that aren't infected, I mean?
Yeah, we get reports almost every day.
When I was a kid growing up, there were no wolves in Oregon. I mean, a few coyotes, but no wolves. They've been driven to extinction by ranchers and farmers, timber companies.
Well, it looks like they're making a big comeback.
Okay, that's weird. got a message on my phone and it won't let me open it.
Hold up.
But what is it?
It's a backpack. It's one of ours. Looks like they almost got to him.
And he shrugged off the pack to get away.
Nah. To buy time. He landed on his ass. Tried to scramble away, but then the wolf lunged. Vasquez dropped him. Two shots.
You can tell all that.
Yeah.
There with you. I gotta say, I'm getting tired running and hiding from these sons of bitches.
You ever take on a swarm?
Yeah, I've done it before. You just gotta keep moving.
Well, look, you gonna join the militia? You must stay focused on the mission. We're not out here to fight freaks.
Being in the shit, killing freaks, it kinda goes hand in hand, doesn't it? Okay, put some distance between us and the graves. The cold weather's gonna bring out even more of them. I think they can smell a corpse from about a mile out.
Part of our slash and burn strategy is to find these grave sites, dig them up, and burn them along with everything else.
Yeah, well, good luck with that. I've seen hundreds of them just in this part of the state alone.
Yeah, we gotta start somewhere. All right, where now?
Keep heading east. Hey, there's a road ahead. Hold up a second.
What do you think?
Is anyone else tracking him?
Not that I know of.
Huh. Well, then he's either dead, or he's got a lot of friends. You see how his tracks have been overridden by bikes. A lot of bikes.
Okay. Come on. Let's see where they're heading.
You said cold weather brings out the freaks?
Yeah. Cold, snow, rain, hell, even clouds.
Well, like I said before, you know your freaks. When we get to command, there's some people who want to talk to you.
People?
The colonel will fill you in, if he lets you join.
Yeah, I think you said that already.
Look, he runs a tight outfit. I just don't want you to get your hopes up.
Hey, don't worry about me. I don't really give a damn either way. Hey, wait. Hear that?
Yeah, it's coming from the logging camp over there.
Is that on your map?
Yeah.
Well, that means it's also on Vasquez's map.
Come on. If Vasquez is there, what would your strategy be?
Well, he's not alone. We know that from the tracks. What's that militia penalty for going AWOL?
Hanging by the neck until dead. Why?
Well, it means Vasquez isn't coming without a fight. See your man?
Yeah. That's him.
Well, looks like you guys need to start doing background checks on your recruits. He seems to be right at home.
Well, let's wait here. I'll radio for backup.
Get your goddamn hands off me!
Oh, this one's a fighter, boys! What do you think?
Come on.
Oh, we'll see about that.
Oh, hell no.
What?
I just got this problem with assholes who hurt unarmed women.
I'm giving you an order.
Order? You see me wearing a red armband? You don't give me orders yet. You do whatever the hell you want.
On running around.
Easy, easy. I'm just here to help.
I don't need your goddamn help.
Okay. I'm just gonna move over here.
Stabbing him in the you know what.
Away from me!
Hold on now. We're not with them.
You think I give a damn who you are?
Okay. How was that?
Just your typical damsel in distress.
Vasquez?
Done. Way done.
Captain Corey?
This is Corey.
We're here. Heading up the road to the main gate.
Hold your position there. We're coming.
What about the enemy?
They've been, neutralized. Hold your position. Curry out. Come on.
We brought up your bikes, Captain. Thought we'd save you the walk back.
That'll be all, Corporal.
So how'd I do? Did I pass?
Pass?
Oh, you've been watching me all day. I figured this was, what, some kind of test?
No. Nothing quite as formal as all that. As you can see, our pool of recruits isn't what it used to be.
Yeah.
But yeah. You pass. Oh. You ready to meet the colonel?
Yeah, sure. Why the hell not?
So, St. John, where did you serve? Before the ship went down. Then you know what an MRE looks like. You know how to recon an enemy position. You know cover and advance tactical maneuvers. So, where did you serve? Marines? Army?
I try not to talk about it, you know? I mean, first year out here, it seemed like anyone who used to wear a uniform had a target on their back. I was in the Army, 10th Mountain. I did a full tour in Afghanistan. So how about you? Anyone who's ex-military has a certain bearing. None of your soldiers have it, but you do.
Like I said, you got a good eye. I was in the Air Force 10 years, part of SAC.
There ain't no missile silos in Oregon.
I was on vacation, believe it or not. I was lucky. Before SATCOM went down, I got hourly reports from across the country. You think it was bad out here? Everything east of the Mississippi was overrun within 2 days. Hold up. I want to show you something.
So, are you familiar with this area?
Yeah, I grew up in a town north from here. It's called Farewell, you know it?
No. It sounds like a fitting place to be living at the end of the world.
Yeah, tell me about it.
So maybe you have been here before.
Yeah, I've been here. A few summers back, me and my old lady, or my wife, we stopped by here on our honeymoon.
You got a pic? Of your wife, I mean. Her name was Carrie. We were married 12 years when... Anyway, it was a long time ago.
You know, I think this might mean keep out.
Huh? Oh, no, that doesn't apply to us.
Why, because we can't read?
Because we don't obey the law.
Speak for yourself.
After you.
All right. You know, making me a co-conspirator, not very chivalrous.
Chival what?
No, it means, right. I never learn. I'm sorry about that.
Oh my God, you should have seen the look on your face.
Oh, I bet it was funny.
Yeah, if I'd owned a cell phone, I'd have taken a picture.
Well, for just this once, I'm glad that you don't.
Oh, come on, don't start on that again.
Hey, I didn't say anything. You brought it up.
You just did.
So, where are we going?
Just follow the trail. You'll see that it's not that far.
It's up in Ash.
What would my mom say if she knew I was out on a midnight stroll in the middle of nowhere with an outlaw biker?
I don't know. She'd say, honey, you better wear your sweater.
Very funny.
Yeah, she wouldn't say anything, you know? You weren't supposed to tell them about us, remember?
Oh, come on, Deacon. I said that a long time ago. You know I didn't mean that.
Hey, look, I'm not judging. I'm just... I haven't told my old man.
That's because your father's dead.
Well, yeah, I mean, there's that.
The question is, have you told anyone in the MC that you're dating a nice girl from Seattle and not some bimbo from whatever strip club you guys live in?
Oh, well, okay, wait a second. No, we don't live in a strip club. I mean, we have a lifetime membership there, that's true, but we don't live there. And second, I did tell them. Yeah, matter of fact, I did.
Wait, you did?
Yeah. Oh, come on, don't sound so surprised. They find your PhDs to be very sexy.
Oh, yeah, I bet. So, you know this is way past my bedtime, right?
Oh, I know.
Come on, stop. I mean, I really do have to get up early tomorrow.
Yeah? How's that going? I mean, you, Well, you never want to talk about it, so...
It's nothing. It's just... it's just this project. I mean, we've got these execs flying in from New York to audit our progress, and the suits at our facility are installing a new lab without even showing me the spec, and...
Ooh, well, I thought you didn't want to talk about it.
Sorry, it's just... You know what? Like I said, it's nothing. Anyway, thank you for dragging me away from all that.
Yeah, no problem.
Wait, is this a pot farm? Is this what you wanted to show me?
Say what?
Well, these are marijuana plants, and that's an irrigation system, so this here, this is a pot farm.
Oh, hey, yeah, look at that, pot farm.
You dragged me out in the middle of the night to the middle of nowhere to show me the MC's illegal growing operation.
Yeah. I mean, you got me. I was hoping that you could give us some tips, you know, cultivation. Put all those PhDs to work on something actually useful.
Jesus, Deacon, what? Okay, I get it. This is not actually what you wanted to show me, right?
No, of course it's not. Come on, keep following the trail. We're almost there.
You think I would learn? You think I would learn, but I never learn.
Nope.
Oh my God. God, look at that moonlight. It is, it's so beautiful.
Keep going. We're almost there.
You ever wonder what it would be like if just everywhere all at once the lights went out and everyone could just see the world just like this?
What, you mean, like, all dark and shadowy and depressing?
I mean, the moonlight, the wildflowers, the fireflies... Oh, I see you were kidding again. Okay, you don't take anything seriously.
Oh, I take everything seriously.
Oh, yeah, right!
I do!
You do not! Like, when I suggested moving some of my stuff over to your place, you pretended that I was joking.
No, that's not true. I pretended I didn't hear you. There's a big difference.
You should have seen the look on your face. And you know, I do have a cell phone and I took a picture. You want me to show you?
My God, you're a scientist. Can we be rational about this?
Okay. First of all I said is that we should think about moving in together. You know, because we get to spend more time together and, you know, take the next step. What's irrational about that?
I have a toothbrush at your place.
Oh, I'm so sorry. You know what? You're right. That is a huge commitment.
Well, I mean, do you know how much a good toothbrush costs?
Okay, see, there you go again. Every time I try to talk about our future, you turn it into a joke.
Okay, all right. We do need to talk about it, and we will talk about it, but just hold on for a second, because I want to show you something, okay? See? This is why I brought you out here.
Why does she look so on guard?
Wow, how beautiful.
Was it worth it?
God, yes.
Hey, there's something I've been meaning to ask you.
Yeah? Deacon.
Will you...
Will I?
Will you, So that a yes?
On two conditions.
Name them.
Okay, well, the first one is that we don't have one of those biker weddings where you say that you're gonna ride me as much as your bike.
Done. I couldn't promise that anyway.
Oh, stop. Okay, the second one is that you never leave me.
Done.
God, did you just bite your biker ring off my finger?
You know what? I think I probably Ooh. Did.
Look at it. It's so cute with its little fangs just like clenching onto the chain. You know, nothing says true love like
dog skulls.
Dog skulls. Hey, what does it say there?
Oh, I'm sorry. I thought you knew Latin.
Come on.
It's Morier Invictus. It means death before defeat.
Wow, I like that. Well, you're gonna get me like a real ring, though, right? Not that this one's
no,
not
absolutely,
great.
Because I just thought that's my ring.
Right. It's your ring. It's more simple, without fangs.
Okay.
All right. Shit. I'm sorry.
No, it's your ring.
It's the lab. I gotta get it.
Okay.
Hello? Yeah. No, it's fine. I'll be right there. Okay, bye.
Is everything okay?
I don't know. They need me back there. What? I gotta go.
This minute? Like, this time of night?
I'm sorry. I have to go, but I promise I'll make it up to you.
Okay.
Come on.
My wife's name was, Beth. No, I don't have a pick. Let's go.
Why would you lie? Just tell him.
Sorry, what's that?
To not have any photos of your wife, family.
Yeah, why do you say that?
Back in the day, everyone used smartphones. That's where we kept all our photos. The phones went away, the cloud went away, our photos went with them.
Yeah, I guess I hadn't thought about that.
My wife, Carrie, her father was a photographer. Old school, dark room, chemicals, all that. Too stubborn to embrace the digital age, I think. If it wasn't for him, I wouldn't have any photos either.
Yeah, well, I hated them. Cell phones, I mean. Seemed like everyone walked around with their noses buried in the damn things. I never owned one.
Interesting. How'd you manage that?
I worked as a mechanic. I had my own shop. Probably had the last landline in Farewell.
the colonel.
You guys are taking this shit seriously.
Colonel believes with enough motivation and discipline, we can achieve anything.
Come on, hurry your ass up.
I'm going as fast as I can.
Just move it!
Is that your idea of motivation?
The colonel has set up a work camp on the south side of the island for those unfit to serve. Some of them require extra encouragement.
I'll bet.
Come on, follow me.
Yes, sir.
Stand up there with the others. Good luck, St. John.
Got your ass too, huh? Whatever.
Hey, man. It's good to see you again. St. John, right? Son of a preacher man?
Taylor, what's this son of a preacher man shit you keep saying?
I'm just kidding with you, man. Hey, do you have any luck?
What?
The woman you were looking for, you and your peeps are riding with.
No.
I need all your jewelry, watches, shit like that. Come on, in the bag.
Sure, man, whatever you say.
The hell you say?
Recruits aren't allowed personal effects. Besides, shit's just gonna get stolen. Come on, cough it up.
Yeah, shit's gonna get stolen.
Goddamn bullshit.
Ten hot! At ease. Visitors are not welcome here. You are here because you were invited, recruited by my trusted officers. When you answer me, start by giving me your name, last name first.
Getting by, same as everybody.
Name.
What?
Atkins, Crystal, sir.
How many men have you killed?
Before or after?
Answer the question.
Fuck you!
We have all done things that we're not proud of.
What?
To survive, to stay alive. The Almighty understands this. The Almighty forgives this.
Amen.
But here, on this woman's face are the footprints of Satan.
What?
Prison tattoos. Proof of what you once were and no doubt still are. It's people like her that are responsible for bringing the wrath of the Almighty down upon us all.
And now.
Take her to the work camp.
What?
Fuck
you.
Get
fuck you.
Come
all.
On, gorgeous.
Like
let's
goddamn
go.
Goddamn redneck asshole. Get off of me.
I swear to God.
What about
get
you?
Off me.
Taylor. Wait. And, no, sir. I, never been to jail. Never killed anyone. Nothing like that.
You've been in the shit for a long time.
Yeah, I mean, I know. I know how to shoot stuff. My dad took me hunting when I was a kid. He was at a camp near Klamath Falls.
And how about you, son? You know how to use a gun?
St. John, Deacon. Yeah, I know how to use a gun.
You're a drifter. Hold out your right arm. 10th Mountain. Iraq?
Afghanistan.
Honorable service, and don't lie to me. I'll know.
Served one tour, served with honor, hated every goddamn minute of it.
Thou shalt not lie. Good man. Hold up your right hand. Do you solemnly swear to support and defend the new Constitution of these United States against all enemies? Natural and unnatural, to bear witness and support to the same, and to obey all orders without question. So, do you swear?
I swear.
Dismissed! Walk with me, son.
recognizes
Captain Curry doesn't bring me many recruits these days. He must think highly of your combat skills.
I've been in the shit a long time.
You know your way around the freaks?
Yes, sir. I know as much as anyone, sir.
Good, good. In here. We'll have the dog take a look at you.
I thought he said dog. Like, what? You have a dog look at me? What's that gonna do?
Pulse is strong. Good heart rate. Got a pretty nasty burn there. How'd that happen?
Had a run-in with a wood stove.
Wood stove, huh? Who dressed this?
I did.
No está mal. Not bad at all.
Thank you.
Keep it dressed or you're gonna lose that arm. You hear me, amigo?
Yeah, I hear you.
I want you to check back with me in a few days.
Got it.
Well, Doc?
He's fit to serve. Lo hará bien. You doing runs out in the shit?
Sorry, Doc. Ya tiene novia. He's spoken for.
Let me guess. The Wizard Island Witch. Vaya con Dios. Good luck, amigo.
Let's go, son.
What?
I normally don't tolerate insubordination, referring to an officer as a witch. But I make exceptions for some of my more eccentric officers.
Yes, sir.
I make exceptions because every man and woman still living has a role to play. Do you believe in God, St. John?
Never gave it much thought, sir.
Well, it's high time that you did. He has a plan for us, all of us, and my part is this.
Sir?
This place. I had a vision. Oh, nothing so grand as those described in the Old Testament. No flaming chariots or burning bushes. I simply woke up one morning before God's plague had rained down upon the world and knew that this was the place.
Crater Lake, Wizard Island?
I call it the Ark. Are you familiar with the story?
Yeah, I mean, yes, sir. I mean, everyone's heard of it.
Indeed. You'd be surprised how few have read the Bible or the Book of Revelations.
You mean Genesis, Noah's story. I mean, that... It's the Book of Genesis, sir.
Yes, of course. Okay, son, let's get you squared away.
Whatever you say.
Now, we don't have much in the way of uniforms, I'm sorry to say, but I think that... here. Try this on.
Seems to fit.
I'll take that.
Well, if you don't mind, this is a gift from an old friend.
An old friend? Not many of those left anymore, are there?
No, there are not.
Okay, soldier. But I don't want to see you wearing it. You're one of us now. And normally we start new recruits in the rank of private. But since Captain Curry has vouched for your experience in the field, we are starting you out at the rank of corporal.
Thank
Congratulations,
you.
Son.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah. Let's get you some work. All right. Now, what was I saying?
You were telling me about the Ark, sir.
Yes, the Ark. What you see here is only a small part of it. Behind us is a whole network of caves and vents that lead from here up to the Cone's Peak. When our work is complete, they will be filled with thousands of seeds, plants, computer files, and books. The world may die, but our achievements in medicine, science, and technology will not die with it.
No, sir.
But the island is more than just an ark, Corporal. It is a stronghold, a fortress. Here at the North Gate, we are stockpiling enough munitions to take the fight to the freaks. We have rifles, grenades, heavy machine guns, and RPGs. We have the equipment to make ammunition. Every type, every caliber. This is our mechanical engineering area. If you need your bike repaired, see the officer on duty. And as you can see here, courtesy of the old National Guard, we are building a fleet of trucks and other vehicles. Once the hordes are cleared from the highways, we will begin to rebuild the roads and bridges.
Your slash and burn strategy may stop newts and swarmers, but it won't clear the highway. It won't stop the hordes, sir.
We are aware, Corporal. The hordes. The hordes are a different beast entirely, aren't they? But we have a plan.
Plan, sir?
Benjamin Franklin once said, by failing to prepare, you are preparing to fail. We are not going to fail. The heart of the army lives here, at the gate, ready to move on my command. These tents house hundreds of women and men, just like yourself, who have pledged and sworn their lives to the fight. But I have something else in mind for you. An assignment that requires more than just the ability to survive in the shit or use a gun. Are you up for it, sir?
Yes, sir. Wherever you need me.
You asked how we were going to defeat the Horde? Let me show you.
Is it a nuke?
Whoa! Now! Shit!
You okay, Lieutenant?
Oh. Hey, Colonel. Sorry about that. Too much acetone in that batch.
Lieutenant Weaver is our chemical engineer. He's working on new ways to
blow shit up.
Defeat the enemy.
Sorry. But, yeah. Name's Weaver. James.
St. John, Deacon.
All this militia shit's just for show. Right, Colonel?
Corporal St. John is new to Corey's unit. If you need anything from out in the shit, he's your man.
Oh, shit, yeah. Yeah, there's a couple of things I need.
What are you working on?
Oh, just the new gelling agent combining naphthenic and palmitic acid.
You working on napalm?
Yeah. Yeah. This dude knows his shit.
Just a lucky guess.
Sorry to interrupt.
Oh, anytime. Oh, Colonel. I'm getting real close, Colonel. Very close.
That's good. That's really good.
Where you going next, Colonel? Wizard Island Witch?
That'll be all, Lieutenant. Again, let me apologize for my more eccentric officers.
No need, sir.
We have one final stop. As much as I believe in Lieutenant Weaver's work, what you're about to see could be, I think, our path to victory. In here.
What the hell?
All right, what is this?
Ma'am, I got everything on the requisition form.
Does this look like fabric softener?
No, ma'am.
Okay, why don't you read it?
Active ingredients. Chloroform and terpen.
Get out.
Shit.
Get out! Matt, I can't do this if I have to do my own supply runs.
I got it covered. Lieutenant Whitaker, this is Corporal St. John.
What?
He's a member of Corey's unit. He's got some experience out in the shit.
What?
Read this. Read this. I mean, you can read, can't you?
Active ingredients, chloroform, aterpenol, benzyl alcohol, ethylactic acetate.
Good enough. When can he start?
I'll leave you to it. Carry on, Lieutenant.
What? Is she actually... she's alive?
Leave us.
I never would have thought that.
Sarah.
Stand at attention.
Sarah, I...
Don't. You're dead. You're supposed to be dead.
Hey.
You're dead.
What?
It's okay.
You're dead.
I'm right here.
Wait a second. I don't understand. I couldn't find you.
I thought you had died, and I,
No, we were overrun. We had to go south. Nero said that no one made it out.
O'Brien and
Farewell
I
was
away.
Overrun. They said that everybody
Over the
was
mountain.
Dead.
Man, I didn't think that
I never thought I would see you again.
Hey, listen. Now we can ride out of here. We'll pick a direction. We won't look back. Come on.
No, Deacon. I can't.
Are they forcing you to stay here?
No, you don't understand. We're fighting a war. Don't you see? This is a war that we can win.
I didn't come here to fight a war.
I can be helpful. I can make a difference, but I can't go with you. I have to stay here. Don't you get it? You can stay here with me. Help me. Look, afterwards, whatever you say, we can go wherever you want.
Colonel's looking for you.
Whatever you say, man.
That's crazy. Wait
a second. Your requisition form. Thank you, soldier.
I never would have thought that she was actually alive. What? Yeah, I'd say hold on tight. What the hell? That is crazy.
Corporal St. John to Lieutenant Weaver. Come back. St. John to HQ.
This is Weaver. What can I do for you, Corporal?
Your requisition form says you need mercury. Any idea where I can get it?
Yeah, sure. It comes from, Cinnabar. Corey's unit's got it out of mine north of Diamond Lake. Head there, radio me when you arrive.
Yes, sir.
Hey, between you and me? If the colonel isn't around, stop with all the yes sir, no sir bullshit, all right? Makes me feel old.
All right, so I'm gonna save this. Oh my god, it's gonna save twice now. Wow, I never would have thought that she was alive. Like, ever. Where am I anyway? Okay, I think they said it's temporarily locked. Like, I have to, like, do all this stuff. Like, I have to do all this stuff to get back up here again. Or is it permanently locked off now? Oh, I hope it's not permanently locked. I don't think so. It did say temporarily. So there is that. Ooh. Alright, I'm gonna stop this now, so, see you.